Rear signal lights are very important to me for safety, because when it comes to you being in front of another driver, you don't have a lot of control. So by having better lights in the back, it being brighter and turning on faster, we're going to give ourselves the best possible chance to be safe on the road. Rear signals are the first line of defense in being safe on the road when you're in front of other drivers. Having lights that are bright but not too bright that they blind other drivers in the road, and also having lights that work properly and turn on quickly will give you the best possible chance to be safe on the road. Now on this truck, I have regular incandescent bulbs on the left side of the vehicle on your screen, and on the right side of your screen, I have the IJDM toy bulbs. These are our hazard lights. These will also be the signal lights as well, but we have them running simultaneously. The great thing about this test is we can actually truly see the difference in the two bulbs and in their performance. Now, it might be hard for you to tell on camera, but that right side is a little bit brighter. If I look away from the truck and just use my peripherals, it does stand out a bit more. But the key thing you might notice is how fast it actually turns on. Really watch the screen and watch how much quicker that right side has the ability to turn on compared to the left. You might also notice that on the left side of the lights on the vehicle, it doesn't fully turn out. It fades in and out nice and smooth. That's because the filament is cooling down and heating up. But you notice in between cycles, it can barely turn all the way off before it fires up again. While on the right side of the vehicle or the passenger side, you notice it's a clear on-off signal. Now, I like having the signals on off because to other drivers, it really shows them that you're signaling. It is much more distinct compared to the driver's side. Now we're gonna perform some brake applications, and I'll let you guys see again how much quicker that the right side reacts compared to the left side. Now you might notice that that LED turns on slightly faster, but that might be all you need to make that little difference in avoiding an accident as opposed to being in one. I truly believe that these bulbs do work better as a safety device. You also notice that when I did quick brake applications, if I were like wanted to get the attention of the driver behind me for whatever reason, you notice that the left side doesn't really turn off fast enough, while on the right side it was off on, off on. Even when the marker lights or the parking lights turn on, the LED was brighter as well. Installation is pretty easy. The first thing we have to do is remove the housing. Okay, our fabric is removed. We can remove the housing. Now, if you're dealing with bulbs that are using gas like halogens and xenons, you want to wear gloves because you don't want your oils from your hands getting onto the bulbs. We're not going to be reusing these, so it doesn't really matter. Just be careful that you haven't been running them so they're not hot. Why should you switch over to an LED bulb versus a standard incandescent bulb? Well, for one, I truly believe that they're safer. One, because they're brighter, just the nature of the bulb, or because you have so many bulbs onto one bulb housing compared to, this is technically just one bulb with two filaments. Also, they turn on faster. So people behind you are going to see those lights turn on that much quicker. It's like half, like it's a split second, but it can make all the difference. Another thing is they're a lot more convenient because they don't have to be changed out nearly as often because they last so much longer compared to a standard bulb. For fitment, you can see that they are identical. They use the same housing on the bottom. The only difference is that this has a lot of lights on it. So for each row, there are three service mount LEDs. There's also three more bulbs in the front of it with a lens that helps to give off a ton of light. And you see, it's very nicely finished. So for those of you that like to build show cars that have transparent lenses, it's going to look really good behind the housing as well. Now we're ready to install our new bulbs. Now you might notice that I'm not wearing my gloves. Like I said before, it doesn't really matter because these don't get affected by oils on your hand like regular bulbs do. There's no filament, there's no gases, it doesn't get hot. But one thing you might want to know when you're installing LED bulbs, once you put them in, test them. If it doesn't turn on right away, you might just have it backwards. LED stands for light emitting diode. It's a diode, so electricity might only flow one way on these. So if you think it's backwards, just go ahead and flip it around and try it again. Once you're done testing, go ahead and put your housing back together. Now I want to know one thing when you're installing or purchasing bulbs actually. You really have to make note of the color of the bulbs or the lenses that you're dealing with. You can see here that I have red full lenses. So I still recommend that you get their red versions because if you put a white bulb in there, it will work, but the white going through the red lens will look kind of pink. And you could do orange, but it might look kind of funny. Red means stop, so let's just do red. Now, because this is red as well, I decided to keep it a red bulb as well. If this was amber, I would make it amber. If this was clear, I will definitely make it amber or red. I prefer to signal amber if possible. It's easier for drivers to distinguish what your intent is if you have different colors. But on some vehicles, it might be all red. And obviously for reverse lights, pick a white one. Well guys, hopefully that gave you a good idea of the advantages of putting LED bulbs in your vehicle. One, they don't cost a lot. Two, they look great. And they're gonna make you a lot safer on the road because you're more visible and they turn on a lot sooner. To see what else I'm up to, make sure to check out my Instagram, Facebook, AnthonyJ350, and check out our website at www.gofasthavefun.ca. Yeah.